I am Angela Greenick. I want to welcome you to my program today, The Awakening. I believe if we ever needed a radical awakening, it's right now. So I want to open up, take a minute in prayer, and we're just going to nail it. Amen. Father, I release the fire and the wind and the rain that will produce a change. And the only way that change will happen is through the power of prayer. And I release that blessing over every household in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. Well, as I prepared today for the program, I just kept hearing over and over Psalm 91. And so I thought, Lord, I believe I better start out with Psalm 91 today. What an amazing prophetic promise that God gives us all through his words. Can I tell you, in my most difficult times, there are times that I have the hardest time even praying. I'm a mom, I'm a wife, you know, I'm a homemaker, yes, I'm a minister, but there are so many facets that make us who we are. But then you come to the times where you're like, Lord, having done all to stand, what do we do when we don't have a prayer? Now you may think, well, that's a really odd thing to say, but not really. In my darkest times, my hardest times, my most difficult times, I grab the Holy Word and I begin to pray. And so today I want to take you through a few minutes of Psalm 91. And it goes like this. It says, he who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I can stop right there and probably preach for 5 hours just on that word. Because when you're talking about the shadow, when you break it down, God says, but in that shadow, in that hiding, in me, like John 15, you are engrafted in him. And as you are in him, he says, I will say of the Lord that he is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. I tell you, in our hardest times, when I think about a fortress, it's something that's impenetrable. You can't break through. And the Lord says again, but he who dwells in the shelter of the Most High, that you will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. And I will say of the Lord, you are my refuge and my fortress and God whom I trust. For surely, 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 he goes, I will save you from the fowler's snare and from any deadly pestilence. And I just want to take that right here and stop, because God is speaking very clearly right now. Listen, we are in the ending of 2016, and it has been an amazing year for so many people. But a lot of people are really going through a lot of uncertainties, fear. You look in our nation, we have a new president coming in 2017. We've had riots. We have some people like the new president, some people don't. There's so many things that are going on with the earthquakes and famines and war and pestilence and war that could possibly be coming. And it's almost like the chaoticness is, it's hit an all-time high, if you will. And God said, in the most chaotic times, I'm right there with you. And those who wait upon the Lord, those who rest in him, God wants to arrest our souls today. Your soul is your mind, your will, and your emotions. And I believe a lot of emotions right now are very fractured, like they are fractured, almost like broken. And people go, you don't understand the pressures I'm under. Well, no, I may not understand what you're going through, and you may not understand what I'm going through. But when we come together as one, we can go further. That's why today is so important for me, because I just kept thinking, Lord, with everything that's going on, I know my greatest weapon is prayer. I just came from Oslo, Norway. I had such an amazing time with Wendy Alex. She's just such a great friend. And we had a couple things that we really spoke on, which is going to be an amazing time. I'm excited for it. But she said, Angela, what is your greatest weapon that you come against the enemy with? And I said, well, really, it's love. I said, I love hard, but I pray. Because I know without prayer, I'm not going anywhere. And I think a lot of times, we all know the word, but my people, Chronicles says, who are called by my name would humble. That's the key. If we would stay humble before God and pray and seek his will, his face. Can I tell you, a lot of you have gone through difficult circumstances in your ministries, in your families, in your businesses, in decisions that you're making, because some of the decisions that have been made are made from your own mindset. A lot of people go, no, it's God's will, but what if it isn't? Do you want Isaac or do you want Ishmael? Do you want the promises of God and the fullness of God? That's where the humility comes in. That's where trusting in God comes in. That's where we dwell in the shelter of the Most High God. I know for some of you, you're really battling because God has taken you out from your mission, and a lot of you are trying to make a position. And you're going to say, well, what does this have to do with prayer? Everything today. Because you're stepping into 2017. It's 5777. I know the word God spoke to me, which I put out prophetically on not only on my own network, but on the other prophetic networks around the world. And I tell you, the one word is this. He said, tell them the seven's flipped upside down. They ignite it and caught fire. But all three sevens, which is perfection, God said complete, but it has to do with sickles. I saw sickles catch fire. God said, tell my people, from 2017 to 2020, he said, it is a time of the harvest. But when you're in a mode of harvest, I'm going to tell you what, your ear as a great warrior, a great commander, a great private in the army of God, your ear is to the ground of God. And you have got to be able to hear what he's saying to you. And that's where the secret place comes in. That's where prayer comes in. That's where God's will comes in. Because I'm going to tell you right now, my whole year of 2016 has been so incredible. Like, who would have thought I would be sitting here today doing our new program, The Awakening? I would have never thought it, to be honest. Like, sometimes God says, but I want to take you outside your own scope of thought and sight and reasoning. I want to take you beyond. I'll tell you, as of August of this year, I knew I was getting ready for Folsom Street Fair, the Witch's Ball. I had all these different things lined up. I didn't know I was going to go to Oslo, Norway, and go do God TV. I've been asked to come back and do an 8-part series with Wendy on warfare and strategies and how to pray and how to bind up in the second heaven and how to release heaven on earth. I mean, we have great things coming ahead, but I just thought, Lord, I can't even imagine that I'm here today. It's 12/12/2016. And I was like, God, if you were ever decreeing governmental authority, it's now. But I'm telling you, honestly, there are certain things that I've had to look at and be in deep prayer about and say, well, Lord, it looks good, may sound good or feel good, but God, is it your perfect will? And this is where the word of God comes in. I will keep going. He says, and I will save you from the enemy's snare and from the deadly pestilence. I will cover you with my feathers and under my wings, God says, you will find refuge. For I am faithful, and I will be your shield and your rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrows that fly by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the night, nor the plague that destroys midday. And this is one of my favorites. And even though 1,000 may fall at one side, God says, 10,000 at your right hand, it will not come near you. I believe that we are in a radical awakening right now. That's why I know that this program is so prevalent, even the name. We did Training to Reign for 5 years, and God said, my people are trained, but it's time to rule and reign what I've given you. And in this awakening, God is doing a radical shaking around the world. And I feel like that core values are being shaken. God is calling us back to the simplicity of who he is. And when it's all said and done, we're going to stand before the king. And I know, like the rest of you, like myself, I really want to hear, daughter, good and faithful servant, well done. Well done. You know, that's my heart's desire, is to stand before the master, to stand before the king, and to have that crown put at my feet. I want that crown for souls. There's soul winners' crowns. You know, there's 5 different crowns, which I'm going to be teaching on in the months to come. I'm going to be doing a lot of teaching in the month of 2017 on my new program, The Awakening. And we'll be right back after a word from what I'm getting ready to do.
God says, I've given you all authority to pray. I've given you all authority to go. That's what the word decrees in Matthew 10. He says, you are to go, lay hands on the sick, they will recover, raise the dead.
This for all of you. No, I will not conform.
No matter how you shake my core.
Come on. Victory's in my veins. Can you turn that up? Come on.
Jesus came so that we would have the fullness of who he is. We take the deliverance and the power and the authority of Jesus Christ in and bring the light in. Every day I make a choice. We should possess heaven and pull it down and bring it here on earth.
If not you, then who? And if not now, God wants to know, then when? What if today I said to you that there are certain areas that God is really calling you to strategically focus on, like really focus on? What would you do? I was just ministering to a friend of mine that has so many ministries, but can I tell you, they are so exhausted and so tired, but they really believe it's God's will. And that's why I'm telling you, the prayer of God is so prevalent, because you're going to get, some of you are going to get rocked in the next 6 months, a year. You're going to get rocked to the very core of your being, and you're going to go, you don't understand. I had this television. I had this meeting. I was traveling all over the world in the seven seas. I was everywhere, Ange. But now all of a sudden, I've lost everything. What's happened? And I'm telling you, these are the times that you need to know who you are in God. You must know the Holy Spirit. You must understand the power and the authority in the Holy Word of God. And I'm going to go back and keep reading in Psalm 91, because it's all going to make sense to you today. It's a key. For some of you, God's saying, daughter, don't they understand that today is a key? And the key literally starts the car. And without this key, I don't feel for many of you that we're going to go anywhere. I'm not saying something brand new to you that I haven't spoken to myself. Can I tell you, a few weeks ago, I'm flying to Oslo, Norway, and God spoke to me and said, daughter, you have to start cutting off certain things in your ministry. You are enlarging territory, and as you enlarge territory, you have to pull back in certain areas. You need to be able to assess what's around you. You need to understand 1,000 may come at your right hand, left hand, 10,000 at your right hand, but you need to be able to focus and hear what it is I'm saying to you. You have to hear and see what I'm saying to you right now. And that's why while I was on the plane, I was rereading again The Seer, the Prophet, and the Knower of Our Times. Because I'm like, God, if we ever need to know your voice and hear your voice, it's now. Listen, there's a lot of familiarity out there. Looks good, sound good, feel good. But I feel like they're Decepticons, you know. A lot of people are following, you know, big ministries or small ministries, it doesn't matter the size, of course, but we're running after tangents, and God needs us to pull back and run after Him. Because I guarantee you, you're going to want to hear good and faithful servant well done. I guarantee you, without a shadow of a doubt, you're going to want to hear God say that to you. Because that's where I'm at today. I'm like, Lord, some of these things I need to pull back in. I'm telling you, I have done so many trips in 2016. We have birthed more ministries this year. Ordained pastors, released deliverance healing centers, and not just in, you know, in America, but overseas. In the Catholic Church in America, we're like booming it. And God says, you have to focus. I have called you as a warrior and a prophetic voice to a generation. And God is radically releasing a generation to know their God, to know His voice. And a lot of times that familiarity, that pulling is going to pull you. And if you don't know who you are, you will be shaken to your core. Have you ever gone into a room and sat down and said, my God, I feel like I'm a five-year-old sitting like a kindergarten. You know, like you're sitting in a little teeny chair and everyone else is around you is sitting in normal chairs. And you're sitting there and going, God, what do I do next, God? And you must know the voice of God. You can't be moved and shaken. You could have somebody walk up to you today and give you a prophetic word. Doesn't mean it could be right, could be wrong, could be for another time. But if you know His voice, nothing shakes you. See, that's what I read in Psalm 91. As I dwell in Him, look, I'm around so many prophetic people that it's almost crazy sometimes. You know, in America, you go down to the grocery aisle and you have 50 choices of cereal. That's just cold. That's not hot. Or microwavable. That's just one side. You can go into meetings and have so much given to you. But what do you take home when it's all said and done? That's what God's talking about today. What will you take home? And I'll tell you what you're going to take home. You're going to take home who He is. What do you do when you are so rocked to your core that people tell you, do you know for the last 10 years that you should have done something else? No, if you know that you're called to do the homeless, then stay on the streets. If you know you're called as a voice, as a prophetic voice, then be that person. But wherever you are today, be happy in who you are. I tell you, my greatest word will always be Isaiah 41. And those who wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. What am I waiting on today? What am I serving today, God? Today could be the evangelist. Today could be the prophet. Tomorrow could be the apostle. I could be building in a different nation today and building a school tomorrow in a garbage dump. I could be doing this tomorrow and doing that tomorrow. But I tell you, the one core that I have every day is I start out in prayer and I go to bed in prayer. And I stay in the Word and in prayer all day because I know that prayer is the key that turns the ignition that makes every vehicle move. I know I have calls from all over the world every day from amazing men and women of God saying, Ange, can you help me? I need prayer. And I always think, Lord, who am I that you would even call me by name? And He said, but daughter, you stay and you know my secret place. I mean, I can have days where I don't talk to anybody except for my husband, Larry. I don't talk to people on the phone. I go off the grid and I just stay in the quiet place because I know God's going to give me instruction as He's given you today. As you dwell in the most holy place, He said, when you commit yourself to me, He said, I will protect you. I will be with you because my word fully will abide in you. That's the John 15. God is wanting us to abide in Him because He is our dwelling place. And that's where the greatest peace comes in, when He is not only our dwelling place, but that's where the deliverance comes in times of danger. I love this. He goes, there are four names that God talks about in Psalm 91. I want to take a few minutes and I would like to read them to you because I know that it'll bless you like it has me. And the four names of God, He says, describe different aspects of God's protection. First of all, He talks about the Most High, how He shows Himself to be greater than any threat we could ever think or face. That's out of Genesis 14, 19. Secondly, He talks about the Almighty, and He emphasizes His power to comfort and to destroy the enemy. Exodus 6, 3. He says, and then of course, the third is the Lord. And that assures us that His presence is always with us. And the fourth is my God, which expresses the truth that God has chosen to come and speak to us, to those He can trust. Isn't that a word? God trusts you. I love, He says, and His presence is always with us. One of my first scriptures I ever learned how to memorize was Hebrews 13:5, and it says, Jesus will never leave me. Isn't that an amazing scripture? That was an assurance for me. I would get so worried I couldn't remember the scripture. I'm in school, I can't read, I can barely think, but I just knew God had had such a call on my life. And the adversity of years that I've gone through to be where I am today is amazing. And I'm no further. I don't think I am today than I was 20 years ago, to be honest. I just know that every day, whatever God calls and ordains for me to do, I want to be able to do that. I want to keep going here. He says, verse 9 decrees, but if you make me your most, if he goes, but if you make the Most High your dwelling, even the Lord who is my refuge, then no harm will befall you. No disaster will come near your tent. That means your home. He says, for he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all of your ways. And they will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. He said, and you will tread upon the lion and the cobra, and you will trample the great lion and the serpent. Why? Because he loves me, says the Lord, and I will rescue you. I love God's holy word. I love the power of prayer. A lot of people go, well, I don't even know how to begin to pray. I would tell you to get into the word of Matthew 6, and it's the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, holy is your name. Can I tell you, I get stuck some days in there, and then I jump over to Isaiah 9, and I think, for you are Elohim. You are El Shaddai. You are Jehovah Shammah. Your presence never leaves us. You are Jehovah Nissi. Your banner reigns over us in victory. I start calling out the names of God. Whew, just saying, the Holy Spirit's all over me. As soon as I start to call the names of God, there is like a shifting in the spirit realm. Can I tell you personally, for me, it's like me picking up a set of keys. It's like me picking up God and going, God, because I know that you are Jehovah Jireh. You are my provider. No matter what I need, I know, God, that you'll make a way where there is no way. Can I tell you, as I'm closing out, it's December 12th of 2016. As I'm closing out this year, I'm stepping in the next year. We have the new TV program. I have more television programs coming on. A lot more schools I'll be releasing. Deliverance Healing Centers, ministries. And I tell you, I have this rhythm in my spirit. But I just get so excited because I think, Lord, as long as I stay close to the Father and hear his heartbeat, that's the rhythm of the Holy Spirit, I know that nothing's going to come my way that I can't handle. I know a lot of times we get hit hard and we get depressed and emotional and overwhelmed and, you know, we get sick or sad or fearful, whatever it is. God says, but those who wait upon me, he says, those who know me, those who dwell with me, I love John 15. That's one of my favorite verses ever. I was a time ago, not long ago, talking with Heidi Baker, and it's one of our words that we love. We're like, we just want to abide in the Father. And I'll tell you, it's always amazing when you can grab a friend to talk to and call. I have a handful of friends that I can call on at any time. And no matter how busy they are or no matter how busy I am, we always get back with one another, because God's going to bring people across your pathway that you're going to need to be able to reach out and trust, you know, and to know that they're a trusted friend, even if you, whatever happens. But God said, you know, one will send 1,000, but 2, 10,000. God is talking about the power of prayer. And there are going to be times it's going to be just you and the Lord, but other times you have a prayer partner. Even before we started the program today, my dear friend, Cassie Brown, she grabbed my hands and we prayed. And I had to just do everything I could to stand, because our fires were going back and forth, because we both know that we're under, you know, torrent weathers, things, weather patterns, things are hitting us. But we know that as we come together as one, God is able to move heaven and earth on our behalf. You know, God wants to move today for you. What is it that you need today? Can I tell you the one key I got out of Psalm 91, which continues to resound in my spirit, is those who trust, he says. He said, but those who trust in me. And God is saying today, but if you will trust in me, he said, even when you're going through great trouble, he said, but those who trust in me, will you trust in him today? You know, really, that's what faith is. Faith is confidence. You can rely on him. He's faithful. He's able to perform everything he says he'll do. Sometimes people go, well, I don't have faith. Can I tell you, I can't tell you how many times I've said, God, if you could just give me the gift of faith. You know, they go, really? Can you ask that? Well, yeah, it's part of the giftings of the Holy Spirit. 1 Corinthians 12 talks about the gift of faith. God will give you the gift of faith to be able to believe for the impossible. You know, as I close out every year, I go on a prayer and fast. And I always think about this is, you know, Christmas time and family and fellowship and stuff. And, you know, my mom went home to be with the Lord almost 15 years ago. And we would just celebrate Christmas like there was nobody's business. And these are the times that I'll look back and reflect. And I think about the words that she spoke to me. And one of the greatest things she said to me, it was her last really thing she said to me was, she goes, but you have to have faith in God. This is really the last thing she said to me. She kissed me goodbye. I left her. And then when I came back to the hospital that night, she had been gone. She'd already been in heaven. And the presence of God was so powerful in that room. But she said to me, but you have got to have faith in God. You have to have faith in God. Because without it, I'm not going anywhere. And I feel like that's a word for some of you. You're pulling off of this. You're pulling off of that. Maybe you're trying to get a scripture here. And you're trying to read or pray and do whatever. But I'm telling you, in the quiet place, God says, there you'll find him. That's what Psalm 91 is to me. That's my quiet place. And for me personally, I know I prayed that for our troops. I still do. Whenever I see any of the military, I always thank them for their service that they're doing. But I think about that word, and that is a prayer. So many mamas and papas pray for their children, grandparents, my brothers. I have family that were in the military, and that was a prayer every day I would pray. God, as they're out there fighting for this nation, God, you know, you pray and protect them. You protect the troops. You protect their homes. Whatever it is you need for protection from today, whatever God needs to do to you, for you today, God says, if you make him the shelter of your Most High, like to me, that's the prayer. It's being encompassed right here. That's how I feel today. Like I feel like I am out in the field. I know it. I am surrounded in a cloud right now of God's glory. And I am encompassed by the angels. I know that I can trust him. I know no matter what happens to me, no matter what happens to me, that nothing will ever separate me from the love of God. I just feel like right now I just want to take a minute and pray for you. I feel like some of you are on your last leg. You go, I just want to give up. I feel hopeless, and you don't understand. Doesn't matter if I don't understand, but I can tell you who does. The Holy Spirit. You know, Jesus said, I will bring you a comforter. That's Isaiah 9, the names of God. He is a comforter. He is the Prince of Peace, Everlasting Father. So, Father, right now, I just want to release in this season, no matter what season they're going through, but I want to release right now, Lord, the Prince of Peace, the Comforter, that Holy Spirit, that you would just surround them. I just decree right now, Lord, Psalm 5, Songs of Deliverance. I just blanket you in God's love right now, that you would feel his presence, that you would know that you are loved and that you are not alone and that you are highly favored and that no matter what storm you're going through, God wants you to know that you are covered and protected in him and that you are abiding in him and he is abiding in you. And that he will never leave you for a second because his peace is upon you. He promises in his words, I will never leave you or forsake you. I'm always there, even in the most quietest times. You may not hear me, but I will always hear you, son. I will always hear you, daughter. And Father, I just want to release right now. I just feel like I want to be obedient to the Holy Spirit. I believe that a lot of you are teetering on the fence. And you have so compromised that you know in your hearts that what you once had isn't there anymore. I just want to ask you to really right now to search your heart. Psalm 139 says that, but Lord, search my heart and thought. And if there's anything that's hindering me, a lot of you are wondering, why isn't God answering prayer? You know, they think, well, it's because I'm in sin. Well, hello. When you start to walk away from God, can I tell you what happens? You have a little stick here and a stick here. And then before you know it, you got a wood pile. And before you know it, the devil's just waiting to set that baby on fire. And God is going, listen, but come back. Come back to him. He's waiting with his nail scarred hands. He's waiting to embrace his son. He's waiting to embrace you right now. say this prayer, Lord, I've made mistakes, but today I'm coming back home to you, Lord. I just want to thank you, Jesus, for forgiving me. Help me, Lord, to be strong in you and the power of your might, Lord. Help me to be everything that you have called and ordained for me to do and for me to be. And I thank you right now, Holy Spirit, your presence just erupt in them in Jesus' name. And I bless you. I command God's blessing to be upon you today and in the days and weeks to come. What an exciting year we have ahead. Have an amazing day. Bless you.